I'm Presley, and welcome back to BiteSized Experiments. Today we're going to be doing a really cool experiment that you might have seen in some of the 10 Bets You Can't Lose videos and stuff like that, which is really, really cool. And we wanted to show it to you because a lot of the time people either don't explain the science or they get it wrong. So we wanted to make sure you guys actually know how it really works because it's a really, really cool concept. And I just wanted to teach you all about it because it has to deal with one of my favorite physics concepts. So let's go ahead and get into it. So what you'll need is an optional straw, a bottle of some sort. You can use these plastic water bottles, but I like using a Coke bottle because it's heavier and there's less of a chance that you're going to blow the bottle away, as well as something small and lightweight that you can fit easily into the mouth of the bottle. You can use like a folded up piece of paper or something like that, but if you're using a Coke bottle like me, you can just fold the cap in half and put it in there, and it works. It fits in there almost perfectly, and it's really, really cool. So let me go ahead and show you the trick. So what the trick is you lie the bottle down, and you keep it from moving, and then you put your lightweight object, the cap for me, in there, and then the bet is I bet you can't blow it into the bottle. So first I'm just going to blow it into the bottle using my mouth. And that happens. You can also try and use a straw, which makes it a little bit easier. You can also use a straw, which can make it a little bit easier to blow on. And it still does that. So this isn't one of those bets that you can be like, I bet you can't do it, but I bet I can, because it's actually impossible to blow the cap in the bottle. So you can't, unfortunately, be like, I can do that, but you can't, ha. So of course I can't show you a trick without telling you how the science works. So I'm going to get into that now. So a lot of times in these videos, what you'll see people explaining it as is that you're blowing air in and that's pushing other air back out. But if that was actually the case, the cap would have been blown into the bottle a little bit, and then maybe it would have come out. Like, I don't really know about that because it's physically impossible. So you really actually can't blow the air into the bottle, and to prove this, just wrap your lips around the bottle and try and blow into it. Doesn't work. The bottle, even though it looks empty, it's actually full with air. So you can't blow more air into the bottle because that space is already taken up. And what you're actually doing is when you're blowing on this with your mouth or when you're blowing on it with a straw, is the air is moving towards the mouth of the bottle and then it hits the mouth of the bottle. And you would expect it to go inside because it looks empty, but remember, it's filled with air. So since it's filled with air, it just hits that air and flows around the bottle instead. And Bernoulli's principle states that fast-moving air creates a lower pressure. So now you have a lower pressure air outside of the bottle, and therefore the still unmoving air from the inside of the bottle is a higher pressure. And high pressure air always flows into low pressure air, so the air from the inside of the bottle blows out, and therefore it knocks the bottle cap out, and that's why it doesn't work. So no, you're not blowing air into the bottle and then having it push it out. It's actually a really cool thing that has to do with air pressure and Bernoulli's principle, which I find really, really fascinating, as well as it's not too hard to get a grasp on, and it's not like some crazy physics concept, and it's really fun that you can trick your friends with it, because a lot of people would think, oh, the bottle's empty, of course I can blow the cap into it, but you actually can't, and as well as it's a really cool and fairly easy to grasp physics concept, so you can explain to all your friends how it works too. There'll be links to some other Bernoulli's principle videos in the description below, as well as please press that subscribe button if you want to see more really cool science content. It really helps us out a lot, and it lets us know that you guys really like our channel, and we feel really, really great when you give us support, so please do that. But yeah, I hope you learned something today, and I hope you will have fun tricking your friends with this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!